Hi there, and very welcome to the first tutorial in a series of tutorials for the Lampy console. In this tutorial, we will talk about the general hardware interface and feature set. At first, let's take a look at the front panel. The front panel of the console contains all the necessary buttons and faders for operation. The front panel differs a little between both products, however, the main part of the console front panel is identical between both Lampy 20 and Lampy 40. Let's have a look at the multifunction faders. The Lampy's front panel consists of either 10, that would be for Lampy 20, or 30, that would be for Lampy 40, multifunction fader controls, each consisting of a multicolor LED, fader, and a button. These may be switched between fixtures, groups, or scenes, and depending on the mode, offer different options. Next, let's have a look at the programming section. This part of the Lampy's front panel contains all keys needed for programming. Take a few moments to familiarize yourself with the buttons found here. It may seem like a lot to learn, but don't worry. You'll be training your muscle memory over time. Also, all controls for value entry may be found here. Next, let's have a look at the playback faders. The Lampy's front panel consists of multiple playback fader controls, each consisting of a fader and a button under the fader. These may contain playbacks, which in turn may contain multiple cues or only one cue. These faders are pageable, and the button and fader function is assignable. On the right to them, there's the master playback fader. The master playback fader may be used for more precise control over a selected playback. It consists of a go and pause back button and the fader. The function of this fader may be configured from within the setup menu Show Settings tab. Next up is the touchscreen of the Lampy console. It is one of the key elements used for user interaction with the Lampy. It features an easy and intuitive to use graphical user interface. Now, let's have a look at the back panel, which is identical between Lampy 20 and 40. On the top left, we will find an Ethernet port. This Ethernet port can be used to output ARCnet or SACN if you have a Lampy dongle, but otherwise might also be used for online software updates, online library updates, and for connecting the console with a OSC remote. On the right of the Ethernet port, you will find four USB ports. Two of them are USB 2.0, that is the white ones. Two of them are USB 3.0. The USB ports may be used for an external touchscreen, mouse, keyboard, or to connect the dongle, or just to connect a USB stick to back up your shows. On the right of the USB ports, we'll see the DVI port, which is used for an external monitor. We will talk about the external monitor in depth in the next tutorial. On the bottom row of the Lampy's back panel, you'll see four DMX ports labeled DMX1 and DMX2. Should you not have a dongle connected to the console, both the 3-pin and the 5-pin connector for each universe are always outputting the same data. If you do not have a dongle connected to the console, both DMX1 and DMX2 will output universe 1. To the right of the DMX outputs, you can find the audio input, which may be used to trigger chases or more. On the right of the audio output, you'll find a MIDI out, through, and MIDI input connector, which may also be used to trigger the console. Next up, let's have a look at the Lampy dongle. Using the Lampy dongle is only supported with the one universe version of the console. The two universe version of the console has the dongle built in already. Without a dongle, the external monitor features will be limited and the console only outputs one DMX universe. That is a total of 512 channels. Also without a dongle, the console does not output ARCnet or SACN. And without a dongle, in the home screen, you will only see one fixture view. As soon as you plug in the dongle to the console, the external monitor feature set will be unlocked. The console will output two DMX universes, that is a total of 1024 channels, as well as ARCnet and SACN. Also, the fixture view now contains two different views. Thank you for watching this tutorial, and I hope to see you next time when we're going to talk about the user interface.